this tutorial I am going to make an gear animation, a simple gear animation, and for this I have made a base. Edit. I have made a base of 60 × 70, and I have made another sketch, a circle with diameter 20, and the first extrude is 10 and the second extrude is 70. And then I have made a gear. I have made a gear by making two circles, one in 30 radius or 60 diameter, and another in 20 in diameter. And I have extruded as 20 length, and then I have sketched. I have sketched a profile. I have project that circle and offset it with 10 millimeter out, and then I have made a 5 millimeter at top and 10 millimeter at down, and I have connected those two endpoints to each other, and then I have extruded until the back surface, or you can extrude it 20 and it is okay. Then I have made a circular pattern with 12 items and 30 degrees between each item. Now I am going to go to mechanical design, assembly, and select, right click on product, component, existing component, and I am going to select the base, open, UCO, and again select the component, existing component, gear, UCO, and as you see it's sitting tight to the base, and I am going to select the manipulate palette, and under the compass you can see that X direction is in that direction. I am selecting the X direction, translate, and I am going to move in X direction. Okay. Now I am going to make a coincident constraint between that one and that one, and then it is not fully constrained. I am going to rotate and select the offset icon and select that face to that face, and the offset is 0, and you see that it is 0, but it doesn't happen anything because it is not updated. I am going to select the update. Now they are sitting to each other, and I am going to delete that image from the start use digital mock-up, DMU, Cinematics. And I am going to select the revolute joint, and I am going to make a new mechanism. It's mechanism one, accept, and the first line I am going to select that one, and second line I am going to select that one, and the base plane is that one, and gear plane is that one, and I am going to make it as angle driven or core, and I am going to, we must have a fixed part, otherwise it doesn't simulate. Then I am going to select the fixed part and select that one. Now the mechanism can be simulated. Under applications, mechanism, joints, I am going to select the revolute and edit definition. You see that it is from minus 360 to 360. I am going to make it as 0 to 360. Now I am going to select the simulation icon, select the mechanism UCO. Now it appears that from minus 360 to 360 you can use it, and it is okay. And use insert and make it repeat. And select that one to 0.02, and you see that the simulation is that direction, and I am going to select the play, and it is going front and back. Okay, it was all in this tutorial. See you on next tutorial.